Home run. I love a good home run story, especially when it comes to job interviewing. Now, are you searching for a tech job, or have you ever interviewed for a job and had no luck whatsoever for a very long time? Well, I want to tell you about a story today about a student of mine who's hit a dead end time and time again, trying to find the right job for him in his small town. But recently, he's been having some breakthroughs, and I want to tell you the story about it today and why it has me so fired up. Now, if you've ever felt this way before and you feel it now, I encourage you to stay to the end of this video so I can tell you exactly what you can do that he's been doing too. Now, if you like this video, make sure you hit a like on it, hit subscribe, and hit the notification bell if you want more content like this in the future. Now, I've helped over 250 people get jobs in programming, and I want to help you through this video and the next one. My name is Jason Humphrey. I'm the founder of CodingCareerFastLane.com, where I help rapidly accelerate coding careers wherever you're at in the process. Let's get into today's story. So this student, which we're going to call Rocco for today's video, because I actually haven't asked him if he's willing to let me tell the story, but I'm going to tell it anyway and just change the names up so we're all good here. The student's name is Rocco for today, and he's been searching for a job now more than over probably 6 months now. And part of this story is to tell you that also people struggle all the time. Just because you work with a mentor and coach doesn't always mean it's going to be easy right off the bat. Every now and then you're going to have a difficult time. And so it's not always as easy as you think, especially if you live in a small town. Now with Rocco, he's been implementing a plan to apply for every job in his town. Some cold applications and some hot applications. He's also taken the time to try to implement what's called the golden ticket approach. If some of you out there know what I'm talking about, I can elaborate more on that another time. But for now, he also has taken the time to drive halfway around the state for interviews with no luck at all, or only to be told no. He also reaches out to his personal network, and he does it countless time and time again to no avail. And what's crazy is up to this point, he's been to 20 in-person interviews with no success at all, not even in the slightest, as though he feels. What he keeps hearing is, oh, well, we went with someone else, or just not enough experience for us, or potentially we wanted to go with someone younger, which he heard that once, and that's totally illegal. And it blows my mind that anyone would even say that. Point being, up to now, is that he's traveled a ton of paths and everyone has been dead end. And so I want to point out to you guys there as well is there's always a light at the end of the tunnel, and here it comes, because what he's been doing lately is this, is really focusing on networking big time and reaching out to people. What he started doing was he started traveling to large organized meetups within 3 hours of his house, which is a long distance to travel for anyone, let alone just for a meetup, hoping to network, hoping to get there and find that there's people there. Also been doing this in his community. He's been reaching out to active people in his community, especially the ones who are hiring. Easy to say, yeah, of course you're gonna reach out to the ones that are hiring, but it takes a lot of due diligence and a lot of paying attention and research to know who's actually hiring, who's actually a hiring manager, and who's also active in your community. And this is where I wanna tell you about Rocco's two big breakthroughs he's been having recently. He'd been applying to jobs in his area, like he's been doing. He found this company, and we're going to call it After Hours Dev, because it was actually a company I made with my buddy Rajay back in the day that was never went anywhere, but I really liked the name. So we're going to call this the After Hours Dev company. And so Rocco really liked this, but was getting no response from the recruiter that he'd applied to. And the job had been up there a couple of months. He'd been applying and got nothing back. And now it's July and still heard nothing. So no big deal. He went on with his day like he normally does. Rocco recently found that the hiring manager for one of the roles at After Hours Dev was active in his community. He saw that the job he had applied for but never heard back from was the same hiring manager that is active. So you're pairing two and two together here. You've applied to it, but you found the hiring manager and they're active. Okay, so Rocco decides to reach out and say that, you know, hey, I'm really interested, would love an opportunity to talk. Here's my background, really engaged, want to learn more, asking engaging questions in the email, and that he would love to set up some time to chat if he was interested. Great thing is for Rocco that knowing that this person was also active, he got a response back pretty damn quickly from this hiring manager at After Hours Dev. that's not the only thing Rocco has been doing, like I said. So what he had done lately is he went to a meetup 2 hours away from his home, went to a meetup, and he went to this event, stayed the entire time to network with people afterwards, happened to get to talk to the organizer of this large meetup 2 hours away from his house, and learned actually from this organizer that there were multiple meetups in his area that just weren't well marketed. And she would actually get him in touch with this organizer in his area, especially of the events right near his house. And what's really great about this is the event in his area actually happened to be the next night. And can you guess where this meetup was gonna be held at? Hell yeah, it was gonna be held at After Hours Dev. So Rocco attends the next night at the meetup near his house. And the content goes straight over his head because a lot of it at this meetup was a little more advanced and talked a lot about continuous integration, continuous deployment techniques, which aren't always the most basic of concepts to understand. Well, after this meetup, like he had done before, he hung around to engage with people, network, and fortunately here, he ended up getting to meet the organizer of this meetup, which was, coincidentally, the director of engineering at After Hours Dev. This is where the story gets really good, and this is what I enjoy and love to hear when things work out like this and you put in the effort and the time. Rocco's name was already known of the organizer. When he actually got to introduce himself and meet him, he told him, hey, I've heard good things about you, Rocco, not only from the event organizer last night where you were at, but I've also heard some things about my hiring manager and how they were excited for you to come in next week. Now, why do I tell you all this? Why do I tell you this story and leave it at that part right there? Why? Well, because part of the story is still remain to be seen. Actually, I can give you guys the update next week on how the interview goes. But I tell you this story and how all this plays out because when you think all hope is lost and you have been trying for so long, I want you to know there is always a light at the end of the tunnel, no matter where you're at in the process. If Rocco had just done one less thing, this opportunity would have never happened. So this next week, mid-July, Rocco goes for an in-person interview with the whole engineering team. And it's crazy to think how one recruiter ignores him, but yet his network embraces him for his outreach, for his ability to take his time and actually spend it at meetups and put himself out there. All right, so I said we would talk about what you can do. And let's jump into it now. First and foremost, make sure you are reaching out, whether it's to hiring managers or active people in your community. Second, going to meetups, even if it's 2 or 3 hours across the state for you and really far away, there could be some good payoff if you stay to the end. And three, find a mentor that'll help you through the entire process because there's gonna be ups and downs and ultimately you want someone on your side who's been there before and knows the pain and the struggle that it takes to get to be successful. If you liked today's video, go ahead and give it a big old thumbs up. Hit the subscribe and notification bell if you want more content like this. And ultimately, leave a comment down below if you're wanting to hear the end of this story or tell me if you have a similar story. And if you do have a similar story and you'd like help, then I've created some free coaching session slots for 30-minute calls to help people out. There is some urgency, though, to this. I've only opened up 5 slots per week, and they book out really quickly. So if you want some time with me to talk about your situation and to get some help, then reach out down below with that calendar.